Today we're taking our ELL students through real life or history alive kind of scenarios so that they can actually see what history is about. Not just hear us lecture about it, but also kind of live it and experience it. So we're hoping that that will engage them more and get them motivated to pass their EOC exam.
Does anybody know who that guy is? What his name is? Yeah, it's Uncle Sam.
We have three separate groups that are going. We have our students from the early college that are acting as our curators, and they're actually taking our first group of 15 through the entire museum, and they're acting because, you know, you learn better. Everybody says you learn better from your peers.
We have Jose, the one that went to Mexico.
Basically, what we were doing today is just showing students from our campus, the museum in general. We're talking to them in English, which not only will help them, but the history too, since a lot of it is going to be in the test. I was actually looking at the stuff that we're teaching and, you know, it's stuff that we're learning in school. Some stuff that is in the museum I didn't know myself. So, yeah, I'm learning with them too.
5 minutes to complete it. So everyone in the group should have an assignment, all right?
We have two groups that are actually in sessions right now going through activities, looking at pictures and kind of putting things in a timeline and looking at quotes and kind of matching the quotes with the pictures. And our other group is in an intense session where they're going through cognates and looking at all the different words. Like when you say government, how many different words, politics, bureaucracy, all of that is government, so that way they're not confused and they understand. Because a lot of it, it's a language barrier. And once we break that barrier, we're hoping that it's gonna, you know, these kids are gonna explode with ideas and be excited because now they're finally gonna have a true understanding of what it is that we're asking them.
My first language was Spanish language. So basically I grew up with that one since I was a little kid. When I grew older, I started to learn English, but it took me a while the pronunciation of the words and getting hold of them faster, even the spelling. I like history a lot, but the thing is that if I read it off on a book, I'm not really good with books. But if people tell me the history, if I see it on the TV and like history channels, because they explain more than what's actually in the books, I understand and I know way more than what I used to know.
We're done.
Our ultimate goal is like lifelong learners and a love of history and how important history is to them, especially here in South Texas, because a lot of our students are not aware of the history that is here in the Valley, the history that our people are a part of. And we're hoping that it'll kind of spark an interest for them to kind of learn more about their own past.
We learn way more than what we used to know. And the stuff that we used to know, we learn it again in a different way. And it's better. It takes a lot of stuff just to prepare this trip, and it's worth it. Because of this, because besides it's fun, we're gonna learn way more, and I appreciate it from them.